Welcome. We've been enough in laboratory. Today, we'll go in the real world, looking at how real rocks deform. We will focus on structures developed in the low temperature regime. Remember the stress strain curve we discussed during the first clip? Looking at deformation structures, we distinguish two stages. In the first stages, deformation is low, typically less than 5 to 10%, and fractures progressively form distributed over the entire rock. Despite the low deformation, this stage is very important because fractures are numerous and have a major impact on rock properties. With increasing loading, the rock will eventually fail, developing a mechanic instability and forming either a fault like the one shown in the picture or a fold. Let us look now at the initial stage of deformation. The most common structure developing are joints. These are planar, very sharp features, often very long and with minimal displacement. Like in the case shown in the slide, joints never come alone. They come in thousands, generally nicely parallel to each other. Joints are often organized in one, two, or more rarely, more directional sets. In this case, they form networks with fracture cross-cutting each other. In the vertical dimension, they can be confined to single sedimentary layers, like in the left picture, or traverse large parts of the sedimentary succession, as it is the case for the rocks on the right. The appearance of thousands of fractures has a major impact on properties of the rock body. It will, for instance, dramatically increase its porosity and permeability, transforming an impermeable rock in a great reservoir for hydrocarbons or water. The fluids massively circulating through the fracture network are often loaded with elements such as calcium or silicium. Under favorable chemical conditions, they can start precipitating, occluding the joints and forming veins. The full closure of previously open fractures means, obviously, that fracture-related porosity of the rock will dramatically decrease. On the other side, very important ore minerals, such as gold, can also be precipitated in the veins, which are then very beneficial. A very important process taking place during the initial stage of deformation is pressure solution, by which parts of a rock dissolve when subjected to pressure. In the case of massive rocks, typically carbonates, pressure solution leads to the development of rugged surfaces called stylolites, characterized by peaks which are parallel to the direction of compression. Stylolites can be several meters long and often form in bundles. You can imagine how much material is put into the system. In the case of a granular material, such as the sandstone, the larger pressure occurs at the contact point between grains. These will experience dissolution, releasing minerals such as calcite or quartz, which is removed and possibly deposited in the intergranular pores. As we have seen, all these structures only accommodate little deformation. If deformation continues, the rocks will become mechanic unstable and faults or fold will develop.